Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm doing an exposition of Matthew 15, verse 21 to 28. In this one, Jesus clearly stresses that he has come to redeem the lost sheep of Judah tribe, to give them, you know, some importance or impetus so they can seek gospel. And the other people, he came to give gospel to everyone, but just to stress it, you know, that the people of the Judah tribe needs more gospel preaching than any other person, more gospel blessings. And still they rejected and killed him. So it was the people of Judah tribe who killed him on the cross. So Holy Gospel of Jesus, the anointed Christ, according to Saint Matthew 15, verse 21 to 28. Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then a Canaanite woman from that region came. Remember, at Cana, Jesus prepared the new wine because they were clean-hearted people. They did not need Christ. And so he demonstrated the taste of a new wine to them. Came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord." Now, the woman, you know, she addressed him as Lord, as an honor, you know, because brother only addressed those people who are spiritually alive, or who Peter used to address Jesus as Lord or Master, you know. So the other apostles who knew we have one Father and we are brethren, they always address Jesus as brother, or as friend. Friend are those who are well together in philosophical thinking or have filial love. "Have mercy on me, Lord, son of David." So she was just reminding him, you are the son of David, in line of David. Jesus was son of David, born of a virgin. So his father was Yahweh, and that's why his name is Yeshua, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua means Adam, firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. And that's why he came floating and left no mark on earth. So she reminded him of his forefathers, or in whose line he has come. "Son of David, my daughter is tormented by a demon." So when you want to, you know, address a person, you mention his family name. "Hey, you come from such a good family." And that's why Stephen, when he went to the temple, he told those temple priests that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. He reminded them of Abraham, who established that promised land under the blessing of Yahweh. And they used to have best fruit in the world, Garden of Eden. And slowly they became unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, and slowly they degraded. All the history, they are chosen people. If you study their history, you can understand what moral laws are to be obeyed in order to be faithful to their forefathers, and then you enjoy all the things of the world. But he did not answer her at all, and his laborers, not disciples, you know, or brethren, you know, brethren laborers, he employed them in the vineyard of our father, you know, and they were not disciples. Disciples are one small people, natural men, who need to be disciplined by the moral of Moses, came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." She's begging, you know. He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." That is, people of Israel was Jacob. And lost sheep was people of Judah tribe. Very clever person. Who from Judah tribe, he started Judaism in his own, as if we are the chief spiritual leaders. Judaism to Jew. And later on, he became no difference between Judah is the tribe physical, Jew is inwardly. Then he left no physical, that he became Jew outwardly. When he became Jew outwardly, then he replaced a Judah tribe. When he replaced a Judah tribe, he replaced his father, forefathers, who were of Judah tribe. And they became bastards, super bastards, because they were born in the house with legitimate parents, everything, but rejecting Judah tribe in favor of Jew, they became fatherless of their own choice, which is super bastards. John 8 verse 44. Jesus told them in the temple, "Your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils." And they retorted, "We are born of our legitimate parents." That's true, legitimate. But when you replace your Judah tribe with Jew, then you are sent bye-bye to your Judah tribe. So you become fatherless, worse than those born of the prostitutes, because you know your father, you are born in father's house, but you have rejected him. And the bastard born of the prostitute, he's seeking who is his father. And that bastards are called mustard seed. But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." Because she was once born, you know. And she, in honor, she addressed him as Lord. He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food." Children's food belonging to Judah tribe, who had become Jew outwardly, one lost sheep, and throw it to the dogs. So he, you know, gave her a good demeaning. He humiliated her, you know, by saying that going, give it to the dogs. So he called her a dog, you know, to the woman. She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the master's table." See, she was so humble. Even she was called a dog, she still was humbly requested that still we eat from your master's table. Then Jesus said to her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. So people go to worshiping these different places, pilgrims, you know, to get healed, you know. It is their faith that heals them. Not going to those pilgrims, those priests over there with the dog collars and with the ropes and other things, they are antichrist. But it is their blind faith that heals them. So our Father God blesses you.